Hello my dear children, how are you? I hope you are fine at your home. Before start our class, let us do some activity, okay? By doing exercise, we make our body strong. There are also some exercise which make our brain strong. Now we are going to do some exercise which improve your brain activity, okay? Let us start the activity. Are you ready children? Okay. First, you have to show five fingers in your right hand. Like this. Put down your hand. Next, you have to show one finger in your left hand. Like this. Put down your hand. Next, you have to show one finger in your right hand. Like this. Put down your hand. Next, you have to show five finger in your left hand. Okay? Put down your hand. Now, we are going to do this simultaneously. Okay? Listen carefully, children. This is the exercise. You have to repeat it and practice more time. It will improve your activity of your brain. Okay. Next, we are going to see the second exercise, which improve your brain power. Okay. First, you have to take your one finger in your right hand. Next, one finger in your left hand. Okay. Now, you have to touch your nose by right hand like this, and then you have to touch your right ear by left hand. Like this, okay? That is like this, like this, like this, like this. Is it clear, children? Now we are going to reverse it, okay? Next, you have to touch your nose by using left hand, and touch your left ear by right hand. Repeat it. Is it clear, children? Now we are going to do this simultaneously, okay? It looks very easy, children, but doing it is not an easy task. So whenever you find free time, do this activity and improve your brain power. Okay. What we have discussed in our last section, that is before the revision video. Yes, we have discussed about the shapes and angles. What are the shapes we have recalled, children? Yes, square, rectangle, circle, semicircle, triangle, quadrilateral, oval, like these shapes we have recalled. And also we have discussed about the how the angles are formed and the types of angles. What are the types of angles, children? Yes, acute angle, obtuse angle, right angle, straight angle. What are the types of angle? Acute angle, right angle, obtuse angle, straight angle. By seeing your test paper, many students are struggling to write the spelling of these words. Now I give you a hint to easily memorize the spelling of these words. Okay, first part acute. You know the spelling for cute. C-U-T-E. How cute you are. How cute the girl is. Like this. C-U-T-E. Cute. Before the cute, you have to add A. You get the spelling for acute. Next, you will very well know right. Next, we are going to know the spelling for obtuse. First, you have to write the spelling for use. U-S-E, use. Before that, you have to add T, tuse. Before that, you have to add ob. That is O-B. That is use, tuse, obtuse. Now, it became very easy to you. What is the spelling for obtuse? O-B-T-U-S-E. Okay, explain to them. Next, we are going to read the spelling for state. S-T-R-A-I-G-H-T. Many of you have very confused with this spelling. Now, I will give you an idea to have the clarify for the spelling for the state. Okay. We know the spelling for right. R-I-G-H-T. Now, between R and I, you have to place A. That is R-A-I-G-H-T. That is, in the spelling of right, between R and I, you have to place inside A. That is right. Before that, you have to add ST. Like the short form of street. Street looks straight. Remember like that. Okay? That is S-T-R-A-I-G-H-T. I hope you have remembered now the spelling of these words. Acute, obtuse, right, straight. It's clear, children? Okay. Next, we are going to see 6th table. I hope you have already known this table. Now we are going to discuss the sixth table. What is the discussion? Let us watch. Okay. 1 6 is 6. 2 6 are 12. 3 6 are 18. 4 6 are 24. 5 6 are 30. 6 6 are 36. 7 6 are 42. 8 6 are 48. 9 6 are 54. 10 6 are 60. Okay. Now children, first you have to observe the even numbers. Okay. What are the even numbers? Numbers which are divisible by 2 are even numbers. What are the even numbers here? 2. Don't see the answers. This column. Okay. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Okay. And see its answer. 12, 24, 36, 48, 60. See the beauty of this, children. 2 into 6 is 12. The number ends as it is. 2 6 are 12. See here, 4 6 are, the 4 comes here also, 24. See here, 6 6 are 36. See here, 8 6 are 48. See here, 10 6 are 16. See the last number, the even number come as it is. You are clear children? 2 6 are 12, 4 6 are 24, and 6 6 are 36, and 8 6 are 48, and 10 6 are 16. It's clear children? Next, again one more information I am going to give now. What is the half of the value of 2? What is the half of the value of 2? 1. So you write here 1. Thus 2 6 are 12. Is it clear children? Okay. What is the half of the value of 4? 2. Write 2 in front of 4. What is the answer? 24. Thus 10 6 are 24. Thus 4 6 are 24. What is the half of the value of 6? 3. Write 3 in front of 6. What is the number you get? 36. Thus 6 6 are 36. Is it clear children? What is the half of the value of 8? 4. 4 with 8, 48. Thus 8 6 are 48. What is the half of the value of 10? 5. It is 2-digit number, so you have to add 1 with that 5. You get 6. So 6 with 0, the answer is 16. Is it clear children? Thus 2 6 are 12. 4 6 are 24. 6 6 are 36. 8 6 are 48. 10 6 are 16. So remaining numbers you can easily write. That is 1 6 6 6 18 30 42 54. You can easily write. Okay. Next we are going to write these answers of level 6 12 6 13 6 14 6 by using this column. Okay. Listen carefully children. Here what we have, 11 into 6, you know already 66. Now, without memorizing, by using this one, we are going to answer for 11 6 is 66. Listen carefully. Here, you have to add 0 here. Okay. Now, you have to add this 6 with 0. 6 plus 0. What is your answer? 6. Now, read this number as well. 6 with 6, 66. See here, next, for 12 6, you have to consider 2 into 6. Okay. Now you have to add this 6 with 1. It's clear children? 6 plus 1. What is your answer? 7. So 7 with 2, 72. It's clear? For 13 into 6, you have to consider 3 into 6. 3 into 6, you have to add 6 with 1. 6 plus 1. What is your answer? 7. That is 72. It's clear? For 14 into 6, you have to consider 4 into 6. You have to add 6 with 2. 6 plus 2. What is your answer? 8. That is 8 with 4. Your answer is 84. It's clear? And for 15 into 6, you have to consider here. You have to add 6 with 1. 3. What is your answer for 6 plus 3? Very good. 9. 9 with 0? 19. Very good. For 16 into 6, consider 6 into 6. Add 6 with 3. What is your answer? 9. So 9 with 6, 96. It's clear? Here is a calculation children. 6 plus 4. What is your answer? 10. You have to write it as 10 with 2. That is 102. 102. It's clear? Next, 18 into 6. Here you have to add 6 with 4. That is 10. 10 with 8 is 108. That is 18 6 are 108. Next, for 19 into 6, you have to add the 6 with 5. What is your answer? 11. 11 with 4 is 114 your answer is 114. Next, for 20 into 6 you have to add 6 with 6, your answer is 12. 12 along with 0 is 120. This is the easy way to write the multiples of 6 for 11 to 20. And one more important thing you have to notice in this is, see here children, what is the last digit here? That is first digit also, 6. What is the next last digit? 2. And then next, 8. And then 4. And then 0. Okay, yes sir. What is the next digit? 6. Next, 2. 8. 4. 0. Similarly, see here, what is the first digit? 6. 2. 8. 4. 0. See the next last digit? 6. 2. 8. 4. 0. If you take all the multiples of 6 continuously, you can easily observe the last digit should be 6, 2, 8, 4, 0, like this only. It's clear to them? We have any information in this 6th table also. We will see it in the next class also. Okay, it's clear to them? So in your home, you have to write the 6th table and read it. Okay? Next, what we are going to see is a new chapter. Next, we are going to see a new chapter, chapter number 3. Name of the chapter is How Many Squares. Do you know what is in the square? Yes, the shape is called square. Do you know what is the properties of square? These are the very important properties of square. That is, all the sides are equal, all the angles are 90. That is, square means all the sides should be equal. That is, length of each side should be equal. Suppose its length is 7 cm means it also 7 cm. This side also 7 cm. This side also 7 cm. That is, all the sides are equal. That is, length of the sides of the squares are equal. And what is the second property? All the angles are 90 degrees. That is, see here, this also right angle, this also right angle, this also right angle, this also right angle. These are the two main properties of square. Okay. Next we are going to see the how to measure the things by using the scale. Okay. Here I have drawn the model of a square here. Also, I know you know how to use the square. See here children. This is the 0. After that 1, 2, 3, 4. After that you have the 1/5th line, big line. After that you have 1, 2, 3, 4 line and the 5th big line. This is called 1. That is, the distance between these is called 1 centimeter. That is, these 10 millimeter gives 1 centimeter. What is the 3 centimeter? You have to start from here and you have to end here. This distance is called 3 centimeter. Okay. You will easily know 3 centimeter, 5 centimeter, 6 centimeter like this. Now my question is, how do you find out the measurement 3.5 centimeter? 3.5 centimeter. See here, you have to start from here 0, 3, and then after that you have to count the lines for 5. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the 5th line. This point is called 3.5, and the distance from 0 to 3.5 is called 3.5 centimeter. Is it clear, children? Next, how do you find 5.2? After that 5, you have to count 2 lines. This point is called 5.2, and the distance from 0 to 5.2 is called 5.2 centimeter. Explain, how do you find 6.9 centimeter? After the 6, this big line is 6.5. After that you have to count. That is, this is 6, this is 6.1, 6.2, 6.3, 6.4, 6.5, 6.6, 6.7, 6.8. This is called 6.9. That is, the distance from 0 to this 6.9 is called 6.9 centimeter. It's clear, children. Now we are going to measure the real objects by using the square, using the scale. Okay, see here. Now we are going to measure this object by using the scale. I am placing the scale like this. You have to keep the object from the point 0. Okay. What is the measurement, children? It looks absolutely 8.4. That is, the length of this object is 8.4. Now we are going to measure its breadth. Okay, from 0 it measures up to 4.5. Okay, now we are going to measure the length of this pencil. Okay, starting from 0 we are going to measure it. So what is it exactly? Its length is 16.5 cm. After that 16 you have the fifth line, that is fifth line, thus its measurement is 16.5 cm. This is the way we are using the scale to measure the real object, but in this chapter we are using the square to measure the sides of the shapes. Let us see. Here we have the dots. The distance between the dots is 1 cm. The distance between two dots is 1 cm. See here, the distance between these two dots is 1 cm. Between these two dots is 1 cm. Similarly, it is also 1 cm. It is also 1 cm. See here, this shape have all the sides have 1 cm. So we can call this shape as square. What is the length of the side? 1 cm. Okay. Now see this shape. What is the length of this whole side? This measurement is 1 cm because it is a square with the distance that is between two points. The measurement is 1 cm. So we are writing here 1 cm. And here also 1 cm. And here also 1 cm. So totally we have 3 cm. So measurement of this side is 3 cm. Similarly, measurement of this side also 3 cm. Very good. What is the measurement of this side? 1, 2, 3. This is also 3 cm. But this is also 3 cm. Thus, all the four sides are equal. So we can call this shape as square. That is, without using the square, by using these squares, we are measuring the length of their sides. Okay. See here. Now we are going to measure the length of these sides. Okay. Here also 1 cm, 1 cm, 1 cm, 1 cm. So totally we have 4 cm. Similarly, this side also you have. What is the length of this side also? 4 cm. What is the length of this side? 1 cm. What is the length of this side? 1 cm. Thus, opposite sides have their equal length. So how do you call this shape? What is the shape mark? Yes, a rectangle. Is it clear, children? What is the length of this side? Yes, very good. It is 2 cm. What is the length of this side? 3 cm. Similarly, it is also 3 cm. And it is also 2 cm. So, this shape is rectangle. I hope you have understood all the concepts we have discussed in this class. And you have to do your homework in the PDF, given in the PDF along with this video. Okay, thank you.
My dear students, in today's activity, you are going to learn about divisibility by 2. By seeing a number, how do you say it is divisible by 2 or not? Here you have a hint. What is it? All the even numbers are divisible by 2. So you have to check whether the given number is even number or not. If it is even, means you can say it is divisible by 2. Otherwise, you say it is not divisible by 2. Okay, what is mean by divisible by 2? If you divide a given number by 2, it should leave the remainder as 0. Then only you can say the given number is divisible by 2. So this is the meaning of the term divisible by 2. Okay. Now if a number is given to you, you have to say whether it is divisible by 2 or not. How do you say? You have to check it is even or not. If it is even, you have to say it is divisible by 2. Otherwise, you have to say it is not divisible by 2. Thus, it is very clear all the even numbers are divisible by 2. Okay. How do you find the given number is even number? See here. Even numbers ends with 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8. It means if the digit in the unit's place of a number is either 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8, we can say that number is even numbers. Here you have some examples. See these numbers. 130. What is the digit in the unit place? 0. So 130 is a even number. So it is divisible by 2. See the second one. 512. What is the digit in the unit place? 2. So the number 512 is an even number. So we can say it is divisible by 2. It means if you divide the number 512 by 2, you get the remainder as 0. See the third one, 794. What is the unit's place number? 4. So the number is an even number. So it is divisible by 2. See the fourth one, 776. It is also an even number because it ends with 6. So it is also divisible by 2. See the last one, 978. So its unit's place number is 8. So it is an even number. So it is also divisible by 2. So from this, what we have conclude? All the even numbers are divisible by 2. How do you find the even numbers? The numbers which are ends with 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8 are said to be even numbers. Otherwise, it is said to be odd numbers. Okay? See the chart, student. What you are seeing? You are seeing the numbers from 1 to 100. Among these numbers, the number which are highlighted by blue, observe that numbers, they are ends with 2 or 4 or 6 or 8 or 0. So we can easily say they are even numbers. So we can say it is divisible by 2. From this chart, you can easily understand that the numbers which are highlighted are divisible by 2. It means if you divide that numbers by 2, definitely you get the remainder as 0. It's clear, children? Now, children, we are going to do the activity for divisibility by 2. By seeing a number, how do you say it is divisible by 2 or not? Yes, if it is a even number, it is divisible by 2. Okay, how do you find the even number? Even number ends with 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8. So if the given number ends with this number, one of these numbers, whether it ends with 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8, it is said to be even numbers. If it is an even number, then we can say it is divisible by 2. Okay. So now we are going to do activity for this. So what is our given number? The given number is 5. Now we are going to check whether this 5 is divisible by 2 or not. Okay. If it is even number, means it is divisible by 2. But 5 is not a even number. It is a odd number. So it is not divisible by 2. For that, now we are going to do the activity. See here, for the number 5, we have taken 5 coins. How do you check it is divisible by 2 or not? By pairing the coins by 2. See here. Here we are going to pair the coins by 2. Thus we get the
remaining one coin. So this is the remainder. If you divide the 5 by 2, you get the remainder as 1. So we can say the 5 is not divisible by 2. Do you understand, children? So our next number is 12. Now we are going to check this 12 is divisible by 2 or not. For that we have to check whether it is even or odd. See here, even number ends with 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8. Since 12 ends with number 2, so it is an even number. Therefore, it is divisible by 2. How can we say it is divisible by 2? See here, for the number 12, we have taken 12 coins. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So if it is divisible by 2 means we have to pair into 2. See here, we are pairing the coins by 2. Thus every coins get paired. There is no remaining coin. So we can say the number 12 is divisible by 2. Okay. Next we have taken the number 13. Since the 13 ends with the number 3, it is very clear that it is not an even number. So it is not divisible by 2. Let us check how it is not divisible by 2. For that we have taken 13 coins. Now we are going to pair them into 2s. Why we are pair them into 2s? Because we are going to check it is divisible by 2. Suppose if you are going to check divisible by 3 means you have to pair the coins by 3. Okay. That's why we are pairing this coin by 2. See here, we get one remaining coins. It does not have any pair. So we can say this 13 is not divisible by 2. Our next number is 17. Now we are going to check whether this 17 is divisible by 2 or not. See children, the even numbers are divisible by 2. How do you find the even numbers if it ends with 0, 2, 4 or 6 or 8? See here, this number 17 does not end among these numbers. So 17 is not an even number. So 17 is not divisible by 2. 17 is not divisible by 2. Now we are going to do the activity how it is not divisible by 2. For that we have to take 17 coins and then we have to pair them by 2. So here we have 17 coins. Now we are going to pair them by 2. Okay. See here, remaining we have 1 coin. So if you divide this 17 by 2, you get the remainder 1. So from this activity we can conclude that this 17 is not divisible by 2. So how do you find the given number is divisible by 2? If it is an odd number, it is divisible by 2. How do you find the given number is odd or not? If it is ends with 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8, then we can say that the given number is divisible by 2. I hope from this activity you have the clear idea about divisibility by 2. Okay. At your home, you also try your own idea for this divisibility by 2. Okay. Thank you, children.